mean that now we are here for that purpose, right? Is that to earn the love of Allah, to show that we care, to do our best, and then to earn the love of Allah by that mercy of Allah, and to enter in paradise forever, right? So a lot of people around us, they have this short-term vision that I just want to have enough money so I can retire on an island, right? Sure. That's it. And then I just want to die peacefully, and that's where their vision ends.
It's not a bad goal, is it?
Well, yeah, that's a short-term goal, right? But then what they're missing out on is that the world ends there,
sure,
right? Death is a new beginning. It's actually sure. an awakening, right? So you're just planning to actually be awake to a new reality, mm-hmm. right? And that's where it counts. So if you want to think about it, like, you know, your air miles card or your, you know, bitcoins or whatever you want to think mm-hmm. about it, so it's a totally different currency, right? So once you enter the death and pass through it, now it's a new different realm, new different world, right? Your dollars don't help, the RSP wouldn't help, your island wouldn't help, right? Now you're going with the love of Allah that you had, the submission that you had, the actions that you did, how you did good in this world while believing in Allah, right? Now that's what matters, right? And that is forever. So this is basically the testing ground, the playing ground, if you will, and after that is the result forever.
I do believe that, even as Christians. As
right,
that this cannot be the all, and then
exactly.
all this earth, this
very short one,
this wicked work camp. There has to be a place better than
right.
than this, which I think most people, whether they're agnostic, atheists, or whatever, believe there is a paradise, the tunnel, the avenue to get there. That's where the
exactly
yeah
right now the point is that, you know, what. Who gets there and who decides who gets there, right? That's sort of details, right?
Yeah.
And this is just like how Adam had, like, you know, everything open, just one limitation, right?
Sure.
So the number one thing that is a stopper, a blocker, an obstacle to get to that paradise, and that is never forgiven, is to associate partners with Allah, right?
Partners with Allah.
So this could be in variety of forms,
mm-hmm.
right? So we believe that Allah alone is fully in charge. He is the all creator,
right?
Right? So everything that exists is created by Allah.
Mm-hmm.
Even Satan is created by
Allah.
All right. Yes, he does evil,
yeah.
but that evil is limited evil compared to the greater wisdom,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
It's created by Allah. This form is created by Allah, right? Indirectly. The ideas, the facilitation, man. The materials, the research, whatever, indirectly, but created by Allah.
It's all from the earth. And
yeah.
You know, the materials
there
they
use
to...
And the ideas and the combination.
The brain that actually deal with it, it's
yeah.
come from where?
Yeah.
And the ability.
Yes.
Okay. At the same time, he completely owns it.
Okay.
Right? Everything is Allah's ownership. Not mine, not Muhammad, peace be upon him, not Jesus, not Moses, not Abraham, nobody has
mm-hmm.
any share whatsoever,
mm-hmm.
right? He is totally uniquely alone,
mm-hmm.
right? No wife, doesn't have sons or daughters, he doesn't owe anyone anything, right? He knows everything, what's tomorrow, what's going to come, what happened, what's inside, what will happen, how it will be if it were to happen, even if it didn't happen, everything is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. Right? And nobody can intercede with Allah except by Allah's permission and for whoever Allah wants. And this is very important, right? Because Allah is the most merciful. There's no one who has more mercy towards you than Allah. Right? Now, so if Allah does not want somebody to be in the paradise, that person does not deserve to be in the paradise. Right? Because if that person would be in paradise, he would just curb paradise himself.
Sure.
Right? So right now, take an example of this. Like, look, Allah has no example. No one is like him. But just for an understanding. Look, there are certain people who are in jail right now, right? You know, let's say if it could be murder or, you know, like child porn, whatever, right? Stuff like that. Now, there's always a question. Should we release them, right? And let them rehab?
Mm-hmm.
Or should we keep them in? When you release them, you're risking other people.
Sure.
So there's always a calculated risk, right?
Yep.
And that's based on human knowledge, human interaction. But Allah has perfect knowledge, right? So he knows the people who are deserving of paradise,
mm-hmm.
right? So people who disobey him, do not even acknowledge him, they think that, you know, there's no divine guidance, there's no divine law, do whatever you feel like, or they think that, you know, this statue, this cow, this, you know, elephant is gonna take them to Allah. You know, they, as if, you know, they have some sort of share in that, or Buddha, or any other thing, Jesus, peace be upon him, if they think, or Muhammad, peace be upon him, anybody, they think that, you know, they have some sort of a share in this world, ownership in this world, that's not a sin that's forgiven, right? From the justice of Allah. That's the basic criteria. If you don't have that, you don't deserve to be in paradise. And I'm not saying that, it's from Allah, right? It may sound bitter, but it's good that we are exposed to it now, then waking up to that reality after death.